flexions, flexions. We will go over about 4 or 5 minutes. Double integration, fungible beam, virtual wall, human area theorems. Okay. Mainly for beams. Mainly for beams. One of them we will do calculated deflection for trusses using the virtual wall. We'll go over the double integration method. Usually this method is covered in the strength of material course. Well, double integration. So we integrate twice to get the deflection. We have a relationship like this. Or DI D square Y over D X square equals M. Okay? You know what we call this with this relationship? Moment curvature relationship. Moment curve. What is the deflection? What is deflection? Y is what? Deflection. Y is the deflection. We talk about deflection of the beam is the vertical deflection of the beam. Y is the deflection. Again, if you have a beam like this, loading, it will deflect. So this is Y. And is Y constant? No. Is it the same here or here or here? No. So it's a function of X. If the X axis along the length of the beam, X, Y, the vertical axis is the deflection. And how much is the deflection? At x equals 0, y equals 0. At x equals L, if the length of the beam is L, is also 0. Here, or here, or here, there is a value. There is a deflection. This is what we need to get, the deflection function. And how much the deflection at each x, at distance x from the left end. Okay? Deflection and, so y is the deflection. So we have here, we don't have y. Do we have y here?
No.
We have the second derivative of y. So what's the first derivative of y? If you have a curve, deflection curve, what's the derivative of the curve?
Slope.
The derivative of a curve is the slope. So dy over dx, slope, is dy over dx equal slope equals the rotation. Sometimes we call it theta. How much the rotation? What's the rotation? Again, y up positive. Yeah, if the deflection down here, you will calculate negative. The moment here is the internal moment, the moment function. This is the moment function. And the sign convention for the moment is, as we learn, this is positive moment. So on the left, this is how it goes. On the right, this is how it goes. Positive moment means tension at the bottom, compression at the top. Good. How about the rotation? What's positive rotation? So y prime is positive. How? Counterclockwise. Y positive. Up. Down, negative. Clockwise rotation, negative. Good? Now, what's E? E, modulus of elasticity. What's I? Moment of inertia. M is the internal moment. M is the internal moment. So, we said, so there is Y double prime. how the rotation is changing. يعني كيف قاعد بلف. How it is curving. D theta over dx is the curvature. How it's curving. If there is no curving, horizontal line. Okay? There's a curve, then d theta. So y double prime is what? What's this? I told you, curvature. Sometimes we use phi for the curvature equal m over ei. What's phi? Y double prime equal 1 over r. 1 over the radius square. Where's that? Nice. So it was covered in strength. Good. Should be covered in strength. So this is the moment-curvature relationship. Moment-curvature relationship. So y is the deflection, right? Y is the deflection. Yeah, we measure the deflection. How much you expect for a beam, typical beam? How much is the deflection? Under surface load, yeah, typical load. 1 centi. 1.5 centi. 2 centi. Not more. We talk about small deflections, very small values. Very small. Yeah, this is too much exaggeration. This is just for to show you. If the small if the deflection is small, how much the rotation? Also very small. All the theory is small deformation theory. Deflections are small, rotation are small. So the deflection we measure in millimeter, centimeter, inch, but very small value. Rotation. What's the unit of the rotation? Radian. Anytime you use it to calculate forces and things, it's in radian, not degree. Very small value in radian. Good. Elastic modulus. What's the unit in the millimeter, in the metric system? Okay, what's the unit? Forget the what's the unit?
Megapascal.
He says megapascal. Shun megapascal, ya sahib. Mega, 10 أو 6. The word mega, it means 10 to the power 6. Pascal. What's Pascal? What's the word? Newton per meter square. So this one is force per meter square, per area. The same as the stress. جماعة, افهموا. E should sound sigma على epsilon. Epsilon has no unit. So E is the same unit as the stress. Force per unit area. Which is strain or which unit? Unit is. So it is the same as the stress. So it's in Pascal or megapascal, but Newton or whatever. Kilo Newton moment, force over meters. I
won't
finish. What unit? What's the unit? Meter to the power 4 or something length to the power 4. فإذا عندك meter to the power 4. Or millimeter to the power 4, we have, what's the difference? How you change millimeter to the power 4 to meter to the power 4? 10 minus 12. Good? Okay. So this is what we are doing. So if I tell you, this, okay, what's the rotation? What's the rotation? Okay, sure rotation. From the original shape, to the deformed shape, how much the member rotate at a given point. This is the original shape, right? Or undeformed shape. This is the deformed shape. So this is the slope. So this is the rotation at A. This is the slope at point A. So this is how point A rotated. This is the rotation. If this is point A, we call this one theta A. Is it positive or negative? Clockwise, counter positive. So this is the slope at B. Right? If this is the slope, how much this? This is theta B. Positive. If this one was symmetric with the rotating W and this, the slope here is horizontal line. So how much theta here?
Zero.
Slope, horizontal line, zero. Zero. And delta maximum somewhere. So, double integration. To get, yeah, we're looking for time you integrate, you have a constant. Again, you integrate once, you will have something, plus C1. You integrate again, plus C2. Now, how we get C1 and C2? Many differential equations. Do you agree here? Boundary conditions, right? So we have boundary conditions. We know how much delta here?
Zero.
So we say y equals 0 at x equals 0. And y equals 0 at x equals 0. Or, yeah, if you have a cantilever beam, it's different. If you have internal hinge, it's different. Yeah, there is boundary condition for each element. Sometimes. Sometimes you get the condition from y prime. In this case, you need two conditions for each segment. And in this case, you have one segment, two conditions. And this one is easy, the condition 0y and 0y here and here. Sometimes you need slope equals 0, and you don't have for deflection. I will show you already. So look again, guys. EI, y delta prime equal n. EI, y prime integrate, equal integration of m dx. EI, y, is what we need, equal integration, dx, dx. Double integration. Each integration is constant and a constant. Good? So this is what you want. This, and this is the rotation. The deflection. You have the deflection function, the deflection equation, but at every point. If you derive y triple prime equal what? Dm over dx. هذا سمع dm over dx. أنا سمع. أنا درست وياه. V dm over dx is V. If you do one more derivative, W dv over dx. This is the most important method, double integration in structural engineering. Everything is related to the deflection. Why? It's related to the W with the four derivative. Related to the shear with the third derivative. Related to the moment with the second derivative, which is the curvature. Related to the slope with this. That is for you guys, this is what we need. This. Double integration. Double integration.
الشباب حاضرين حضور كثير هون عشان الكويز
في كويز
ما بعرف ايش حسب حسب ما حكوا كنت طلعوا عن الصوت
EI constant. Everything, all the units, kilo newton, comma, meter. Okay? So we have 50 kilo newton at 2 meter, then 3 meter. So the beam is 5 meters long. Good. So what's the reaction? How much? So we have 30 times 5, 150 plus 50, 200. How much is the moment? Reflection delta and the rotation theta at C. Delta and theta, and y and y prime at C, or at B, or at any location. Or find the moment and shear function. So we have the equation, EI, y delta prime equal m, right? So do we have one m? So if we have one function everywhere, we have two functions, right? We have function for the first segment, and function for the second segment. Alright, so segment AB. Segment AB. You need the moment function. So you take a cut at distance x. So x equal, greater or equal 0, less or equal 2. You need the moment function from here to here. This is your cut. This distance is x. This distance is x. I am looking for m positive. So we have 200. We have 4, 7, 5, and the load is 30. So m equal the opposite minus the width. The opposite minus the width. 200x. Minus 30 times x times 6 over 2. So 30. The moment is width, so it's minus. This is 15. So that's the moment function. Now just do it. EI y double prime equal this. Well, m, this, 200x minus 15x squared minus 475. Minus 475. So integrate once. Y prime equal 200x squared over 2 minus 15x cubed over 3 minus 475x plus C1. K, M, L, C10, C. EI, integrate again. Y, integrate one more. Equal. C1. We need C2. Where we get them from? Boundary conditions. Boundary conditions. So what do we have? Boundary conditions here in this segment. Fish moment.
Y.
Y equal 0 at
A.
At A or should A?
X
equals 0. So Y, the deflection here, 0, no deflection. At X equals 0. Right? How much the rotation here?
Zero.
The fixed allow for rotation? Nothing. So y prime equals 0 at x equals 0. And boundary conditions. Y prime equals 0 at x equals 0. Y equals 0 deflection at x equals 0. See, you get the two conditions at one support. One support. Sometimes different. Proof myself. So I'm telling you, y prime 0 at x equals 0. So this is 0. Look, yeah.
Zero.
Look, 0.
Zero.
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 Zero. Zero. Zero. Means?
C1
is 0. If C1 is 0,
C1x
is 0. Okay. So y equals 0 at x equals 0. 0. 0. 0.
0.
So this is it. That's the slope function, and that's the deflection function or equation. Now, if I ask you, what's the deflection at x equal 2?
No, x equal 2. Deflection?
Deflection.
What?
100 over 3, 2 cubed, minus 5 over 4, 2 to the power 4, minus 475 over 2, 2 squared. That's it. Y, so you want Y, you divide by EI, everything by EI. What's the slope at x equal 2?
Yeah.
What's the slope? Yeah, if you check the slope at x equal 0, it's 0. Wow. Good? So if I ask, what's the deflection at x equal 4?
That's the matter of fact.
So this equation, these functions are only for this.
Zero case.
Zero.
Only for this. So let's check. What's y prime at x equal 2 and what's y at x equal 2? How much? Do this for me. Calculate this. Y prime at x equal to here. Let's handle it. Someone check it. Over EI. At the end, y prime, you need over EI. So minus 5, minus 0 over EI. So y, here.
Marcus, centimeter faster.
Yep.
Centimeter faster.
Someone check.
Centimeter faster.
Faster up?
Faster W.
Good. Okay? Mm. So see negative. Now what does it mean? Down. We know it's down. Makes sense. Rotation makes sense and reflection makes sense. Good? So that's the answer. So now, why I told you the units kilo Newton meter? I tell you what's the magnitude of y deflection. If I give you values for E and I, you have to plug them here with the units. Yeah, I think values for E. Yeah, what's E for steel?
Steel.
Steel. 200 gigapascal or 200,000 megapascal. This equal 210 newton per meter squared. That's pascal. You cannot apply it here. Why? Because this number is in kilonewton. In, but you have to plug it here. 210.6. This is ready to go. Ready to go. Don't change this. maybe kilonewton or something with length cube or length square. Change this. If I give you I equal like 500 or 600 millimeter to the power 4, multiply 10 minus 12 to change it to meter to the power 4. For this segment BC, we have two options. Should alumna to get the moment function. We can set up our axis here or set up our axis here. You see? It doesn't matter. I taught you both ways. Alumna didn't get it. The same answer. That's how I want to show you from here. That's at C. Doesn't matter, Shabab. This is easy. This is easier. Why? And if you made a mistake in the reactions here, you will not carry the mistake. If I خربطت هذول الثنتين وخذت برضو من هون الريفرنس, everything is wrong. عم بيجي من هون بتجيب لك واحدة صح. If we get something wrong. بس من عارف إنك تعرف تعملهم عشان هون تصير عندك freedom. So you have freedom now. الامتحان عشان أعرف إنك عارف ولا مش عارف. Good. Now look, Hessa. This is x. So what's the moment now? I'm looking for the moment.
Moment about
rotation. You only show okay, bro. That's positive. Either if you switch this one, you are toast. Yeah, if you make a mistake in this sign, you go somewhere else. Big mistake. This is positive m. That's positive m on the left. That's positive m on the right. Now, m easy here. Equal?
Minus.
Be careful. It's with?
Minus.
30 x squared over 2. Minus. Minus. Plus. Big mistake. One solution. They have reaction sound. That's your moment. Once you have this one, integrate. That's it. Integrate. So YEI. So for this is for segment BC. X greater or equal to. This or equal to 5.
Zero.
And my zero is from there. X positive to the left. So EI, Y, negative Y equal M, equal
minus 5 X.
So EI, Y prime equal
minus 5 X.
EI, Y. Last time we stopped here for the segment BC, we said we're going to go from here, x from here. For this method, remember, you want to get the boundary condition for this segment from this segment. The reference axis for this segment is y positive and x positive, right?
So
let me finish this. This and this. Look, we We said for this method, the double integration, y positive, half, up, m positive. This is m positive. Theta positive.
Counterclockwise.
X positive.
To the right.
X positive to the right. But in my case, this is my x positive. This is the point of 0, 0. That's the x positive. For the derivation of EI, y double prime as a function of x equal m as a function of x, x positive to the right. Good? So in this case, when I do y prime at x equal minus 3 equal this, they are equal. They are equal. Slope is slope. Moment is moment. Deflection is deflection. Down, down. Again, this point B, from the left, it will go down. From the right, it will go down. But for this one, this is positive, this is negative x. That's why it did not come with us. I mean, we get the wrong value for C2. If we do this, we have the following. So this one, how much? Minus 5.9 over EI, right? Minus 5.9 over EI. So EI over EI will go. So minus 5.9 equal
minus
5 x cube. What's x cube?
Minus
3 cube. Minus 3 cube. Plus 1. Minus? This is minus. So C1 equal, this is 27 times 5, this is positive, take it to the other side, how much? Minus 725. So this is minus 725. And this is minus 725. So again, now y at x equal minus 3
minus.
Equal this. EI will cancel. So minus 7 over 3 over 3 equal
minus
5 over 4 x minus 3 to the power 4. See what we have. Minus 725 times minus 3 plus C2. You do this, you get C2. We must have it negative. Someone check. This is negative, will become positive. This is negative, this is positive, you take it, become negative. How much?
Equals
0 here. equal minus 7 to 5 over EI. If the question is, what's the maximum deflection in this beam and what's the maximum slope for this beam? The maximum deflection is here, minus 2770 over EI. The maximum slope is
minus
7 to 5 over EI. If you took your axis, your cut from here, yeah, you come your x from here, straight up, you will have no problem. But your x will be greater or equal to
2,
less or equal 5. Less or equal 2. We did this. Remember. Your x will be less or equal to 5. You get the function for this one. The maximum will be at x equal 5. Y prime and
y.